Hi, this video is presented to you by the Professional Development Team of Oxford University Press, Pakistan. Today we will learn how to have fun with homophones in our classrooms. According to Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary, the definition of homophone is a word that is pronounced like another word but has a different meaning and spelling. For example, plain and plain. Let's read this poem and see how homophones can add beauty to our writings. Lisa's cat. Lisa had a blue cat who blew inside her hat. Lisa had 8 other cats who often ate lots of rats. The cats made a big mess one day, and then the maid began to say, "You have too many cats, 2 on my head and 7 under your bed." Now Lisa knows all this, so she tapped her nose and said, "Hey miss, my dear maid, everything you say is true, so I'll trade my 9 cats for 9 deers, that's what I'll do." Homophones are without a doubt the reason why our students make spelling mistakes on daily basis. For example, they can confuse morning spelled as m-o-u-r-n-i-n-g for the word morning spelled as m-o-r-n-i-n-g. Homophones are confusing little words for students as they sound the same but have different meanings and usually different spellings. While there are literally hundreds of homophones in English language, once your students have grasped the importance of learning homophones, they will be better readers and writers. We can make learning homophones easy and fun by adding images. You can collect various images and make your own fun game to match the correct homophone to the image. For example, flower, flower, sail, and sail. Encourage your child to write down the homophones they come across in a notebook and use them in their own simple sentences. Or you can give them sentences where they identify the correct homophone to complete their sentence. Homophones are an important part of learning the English language, and learning them set your child on the right track to correct spelling. Teachers can play bingo with their students using bingo chart while teaching homophones to add fun to their teaching and develop the interest of their students. To play bingo game, ask your students to produce at least 12 pairs of homophones and write them on whiteboard. The teacher will ask the students to make a bingo chart having 9 cells and randomly select any 9 words from the list of homophones and write them in these cells. While selecting words from the list, they should keep in mind that they cannot select the same pair of the words, such as if they select the word except that is spelled as A-C-C-E-P-T, then they will not choose except E-X-C-E-P-T as their second word. Now the teacher will randomly make sentences of the words given in the list. While making sentences of the words, the teacher will skip the selected word in the sentence and let the students get the word. For example, there are 7 days in a dash. The students will get the correct word, and all those who have written the word week in their bingo chart will put a cross over it. The teacher will keep on making sentences till any of the students get all his words crossed and shout out, "Bingo!" Teacher can have a chart of homophones in their classrooms, and students can add on new homophones to it throughout the year. So have fun with homophones. Thank you for joining.